But for sure sa IRS mo siya ipapadala at hindi sa bahay ng ex mo.
Okay Charo. Lang, mahaba ang pila, magantay tayo, sanay tayong magantay.
Char. Well, anyway. Hi guys, this is Ian and welcome back to another video. And if you like my haircut, subscribe to my channel, Char. Well, anyway, I'm so happy that I finally had the time to do this because as you all know, I recently moved to my new place and it has been a crazy week for me. I was very busy, but I'm glad. I would say I'm 80 to 90% settled down at the moment, so I have some extra time tonight. It's Monday night here, so I'm making this video. But before I start, I just want to put a disclaimer here that this video is for education purposes only, and this is just for information purposes only. And because this time I want to discuss or share with you guys the important things that a green card holder should know or should do prior to moving to another city or another state, or just basically when you change your address, okay? Number one, guys, is so easy, but I still want to go through it because oftentimes it's the little things that we tend to forget. Katulad ng kung paano ka kinalimutan ng ex mo, charot lang. Number one is you want to make sure that you have changed your address in all your bank accounts. As you all know, we do everything here cashless, like shopping, groceries, and like bills are also cashless. So the problem would be some of your future transactions would actually not go through because of personal information inconsistencies. So you want to make sure that you give your bank heads up or do it via mobile applications. All their mobile applications here, guys, actually are very user-friendly, so you can do it yourself, okay? Guys, is you want to call USPS or the Post Office Service and give them your forwarding address. Ang purpose nito, guys, is para lahat ng mga lumang mails mo na naka-address pa sa lumang address mo or lumang bahay mo, they will be forwarded immediately or automatically to your new address, including na ang letter ng ex mo. Charot lang. Okay, you can do it online. They have a website, actually. I will be posting that in the description box below so you can access that. They actually charge $1.05. Murang-mura, mas mahal pa ang ginastos mo sa ex mo. Charot. Thirdly, guys, because you are a green card holder, it is imperative for you to inform USCIS of your change of address or the United States Citizens and Immigration Services. Now, in order for you to do that, if you have the login information of your USCIS account, just log in into your account and go to change of address and you can take it from there. However, I know that most of the nurses coming from the Philippines, they do not have the login information of their USCIS account. Maybe it's with their employer, or maybe it's with the immigration lawyer, or maybe it's with their agency. I just do not know, but there is another way. Just go to USCIS website and then look for form AR-11. That is the immigrants change of address form. Just download that, fill up the form, and then send them over to USCIS via email. And if you want to give them a call, you can also give them a call just to make sure that they have received the information and you are safe. Next, guys, is you need to inform the IRS or the Internal Revenue Service of your change of address. Now, there are two ways in order for you to do that. Number one, give them a phone call, which is kind of hard this time because of the pandemic. Or number two, go to their website and look for Form 8822. Now, that is the change of address form under Internal Revenue Service. You just have to download that and fill up the form and send it over to the IRS address, depending on what state you are currently at. Now, there is a specific instructions on the second page of Form 8822. Look for that and just follow the instructions. But for sure, sa IRS mo siya ipapadala at hindi sa bahay ng ex mo. Shut up! Lastly, guys, is you need to change the address of your driver's license, but you do not do this under DMV. You have to call Deputy County Registrar and get a booking, but because of the pandemic, medyo mahaba ang pila. Like for me, nagbook ako last week and my appointment is set on January 2021. Okay lang, mahaba ang pila, magantay tayo, sanay tayong magantay. Char! But anyway, that's all that I want to share with you guys. If you have some questions, you can directly send me a message on Facebook or you can just DM me on Instagram, whatever you wish. I'll be there to answer your questions. See you again next time. Bye-bye.